Expect pretty much all day. More on the weather throughout the morning. But first, let's talk about the presidential election. 4 days after Election Day, former Vice President Joe Biden has been declared the winner in Pennsylvania, the projected winner there. The state, a battleground state with 20 electoral votes, apparently enough to be the decisively tip in the election, tipping it to Mr. Biden. We declare him, or the party declares him as President-elect Biden. Now, with more on what is currently happening and what will happen next, we turn our attention to KUSI contributor Dan Eaton. He is a legal analyst and a constitutional expert. Dan, great to see you again this morning.
Good to be with you, Liz.
So we know President Trump is disputing the election in court. I'm going to ask you some specifics about that in a moment, but you know the Constitution. I want to know, what is next in the process? What is supposed to be happening right now?
Well, what's happening are legal challenges in a handful of states, as you've already said. And it's important when you said, Liz, he's been declared the winner, is that there's a difference between being declared the winner and being certified the winner, and then the electors being named by these various states. But the next step is for this litigation to play out as to whether there were irregularities in process with respect to observers, whether there were irregularities with respect to the handling of mail ballots and so on. There was a declaration that the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, Lindsey Graham of South Carolina, received that suggested some of the mail ballots had been backdated in Pennsylvania. Those are the kinds of issues that a court is going to want to look at in the days ahead.
All right. So I want to ask you now about, and we talked about this a little yesterday since you were standing by as we were listening to Rudy Giuliani, one of President Trump's lawyers, talk about the litigation. You know, they've already filed a number of lawsuits. They plan to file more lawsuits in Pennsylvania. How does this play out, and how does this change the course of the election process?
Well, it doesn't really change the course of the election process because the president's famously said it is what it is, but it could change ultimately how certain votes are counted. That's really the critical question, is the votes are in. Nobody's contending that voting should continue to go on. The question is which votes are going to continue to be counted, and that's really going to be what they're going to look at. Are there irregularities in process that are sufficient, and with concrete evidence, I might add, that are sufficient to result in a change in the outcome in some of these pivotal states?
Yeah, you mentioned concrete evidence because we know, ballots are outstanding. They're continuing to be counted. There's going to be a recall in Georgia and Wisconsin. We know that.
Recount, you meant, I'm sure.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yes, thank you. And these misconduct allegations, which is what you're alluding to about, you know, having evidence in place, concrete evidence, how difficult is that in court? I mean, the burden of proof is with the lawyers, right?
Clearly they're going to be with the president's lawyers, as you said. That's right. I mean, that's going to be the hard thing. It's easy to make allegations. It's harder to provide substantiating evidence to indicate that and to prove that to the satisfaction of a court when you're looking at the stakes that are that high. And also you have this issue of the reliance of voters who cast ballots based on the rules that were announced. Shouldn't their intent be respected and their ballot counted, notwithstanding potentially some irregularities or questions about whether those ballots should be counted in light of the fact that they were received after the election because of the pandemic-related mail delays? Here's the interesting point, Liz, though, that unlike the pandemic, where we really don't know where it's going to end, and we do have an end date for this, and that is December 8th, which is the deadline for states to designate their electors. So we do know when this is going to end. We just don't know how it's going to end. Mm. And that's what these court processes are all designed to address.
That's a very good point. Thank you for laying that out for us, Dan. Is there anything else that stands out to you?
Yes. At the end of the day, there's a lot of talk about the Supreme Court getting involved. But understand that unlike everybody talking about Bush versus Gore back in 2000, the fact is that that was one state. You're talking about multi-state. It's a multi-state front. And not all of these issues are obvious for the Supreme Court to get involved. We may never know whether Amy Coney Barrett would recuse herself in any kind of these proceedings, because it may never get that far. But there is one pending case before the U.S. Supreme Court involving Pennsylvania, and that's going to be one to watch in the near term, since all the attention is on Pennsylvania right now.
Dan Eaton, legal analyst and constitutional expert, thank you so much. We so appreciate your expertise on the matter.
Good to be with you, Liz.
Okay, take care. Talk to you soon. If you are